Sri Lanka is a multinational, multicultural, multi-religious country which has a history of more than 2,500 years. Ancient cities, tropical beaches, exotic wildlife with a vast biodiversity are few of many significant uniquenesses of this island nation. The Ministry of Defense of Sri Lanka ensures the peace and security over its stretch of 65,000 square kilometers of land and 5,1700 square kilometers of exclusive economic zone, which is the aspiration of the people as a unitary sovereign state. The exclusive economic zone is 7 times bigger than its land stretch. The functions of the ministry are formulation of policies in relation to the defense and security in conformity with the national and international laws, coordinate and collate information and disseminate intelligence related to the national security, and also implementation, monitoring and evaluation of policies, programs and projects of national development related to the subjects under its departments, state corporations and statutory institutions to ensure secured country. The vision of the ministry is for a secure and peaceful country. The mission is formulating and executing strategic plans and policies for a secure, safe, and sovereign country with territorial integrity. The Ministry of Defense is administered by 6 additional secretaries, Director General Accounts and Finance, Chief of National Intelligence, and Military Liaison Officer. The post of Minister of Defense was first created in 1947 as the Minister of External Affairs and Defense. As the British ruled the country, Ceylon was the name used until gaining the independence in 1948. The governor of Ceylon was the representative of the country to the head of the British colonial administration and also the commander-in-chief of the British forces in Ceylon. Colonial secretary, who was also called the lieutenant governor, was the secretary to the armed forces and held the command in the absence of the governor under the British rule. With Ceylon gaining self-rule and dominion status with the creation of Dominion of Ceylon in 1948, the office of the governor was replaced by the governor general, who represented the British monarch as the head of the state. Minister of External Affairs and Defense since 1947 was held by the Prime Minister, with a parliamentary secretary for the Defense and External Affairs, who was an elected parliamentarian and was the foreign minister by virtue of his office. The Republic Building at the Republic Square, standing tall majestically in the city of Colombo, was the home to the Ministry of External Affairs and Defense, Ceylon Army, Royal Ceylon Navy, Royal Ceylon Air Force, Police Department, Ceylon Overseas Service, Department of Information, Department of Immigration and Emigration were the organizations that were administered under the purview of the Ministry of External Affairs and Defense. Being the Prime Minister, D.S. Senanayake from 1947, Dudley Senanayake from 1952, General Sir John Kothalavala from 1953, SWRD Bandaranaike from 1956, Vijayananda Dahanaike from 1959, Dudley Senanayake from March 1960, Sirimau R.D. Bandaranaike from July 1960, Dudley Senanaike from 1965, Sirimau R.D. Bandaranaike from 1970, and J.R. Jayawardena from 1977 respectively held the appointment of Minister of Defence and Foreign Affairs. With the amendments to the Constitution of Sri Lanka in 1977, the Executive Presidency was established, and thus the late President, His Excellency Junius Richard Jayawardena, became the head of the state and by virtue the Minister of Defence as well. Following late President J.R. Jayawardena's term, President Ranasinghe Premadasa, President Jingiribanda Vijayathunga, President Chandrika Kumarathunga, Minister Thilak Marapana, President Chandrika Kumarathunga, President Mahinda Rajapaksha, President Maithripala Sirisena, President Gotabaya Rajapaksha, and the current President Ranil Wickremasinghe has held the appointment of Minister of Defence of Sri Lanka. Similarly, following the amendments to the Constitution, Colonel C.A. Dharmapala, General D.S. Artikala, General S.C. Ranathunga, Air Chief Marshal Walter Fernando, General Hamilton Wanasinghe, Mr. R.K. Chandranand de Silva, Mr. K. Austin Fernando, Mr. L.D.C. Herath, Major General A.K. Jayawardena, Lieutenant Colonel Gotabaya Rajapaksha, Mr. B.M. U.D. Basnaike, Mr. Karunasena Hettiarachchi, Mr. Kapila Vaidyaratna, Mr. Hemasiri Fernando, General S.H.S. Kotigoda has held the Secretary to the Ministry, and General Kamal Gunaratna is holding this prestigious appointment today. After securing the country from the brutal terrorism of LTTE, which killed thousands of innocent civilians, destroyed resources of the country, conscripted innocent children as child soldiers, and bombed religious places, the post-conflict focus of the ministry was expanded from nation building. Having the Urban Development Authority attached under its purview, the ministry was renamed as Ministry of Defence and Urban Development, thus engaged in a comprehensive urban development, introducing pragmatic traffic plans and unveiling beautiful panorama of the glamorous city of Colombo. Controlling the illegal migrants, prevention of smuggling violating maritime boundaries, enhancing the religious harmony of the state, undertaking research and development project, prevention of the influx of drugs into the country, preserving of archaeological sites of eastern Sri Lanka are some of main functions and roles of the ministry today. Providing and coordinating the disaster relief activities and calamities of various nature, assisting the Ministry of Health to fight the COVID-19 pandemic to be among the most efficient countries who control the pandemic, are significant events among many other. Conducting disaster relief and assistance operations within and beyond boundaries is an evidence of strong diplomatic ties of the ministry. Ministry of Defense coordinates the sending of troops for United Nations missions in various parts of the world. Involves in students exchanging programs for multiple military trainings and academic disciplines, which demonstrates the noteworthy diplomatic relations of the ministry. The Ministry of Defense building houses the office of the Chief of Defense Staff and all Triforces under one roof, ensuring the smooth administration and coordination among the organizations. Today, the Ministry of Defense stands as one of the strongest pillars of the government and the nation, taking part in various nation-building programs, ensuring a secure Sri Lanka.